Crude oil has been blood enabling the current affluent society. Long time ago, we could get the crude oil by simply digging in the ground, but now we can't do it anymore. Instead, we should get it from deep sea. So apparently, the securing the crude oil is getting much more difficult. So crude oil has been used to produce fuels and chemicals. All of the gasoline, diesel, jet fuel are from crude oil. Even fertilizer, which contribute to food production greatly, is also from crude oil. Various chemicals, paint, rubber, fabric, and many plastics are also from crude oil. So all of these fuels and chemicals are produced in these mega giant plants. Crude oil would get into the distillation tower, and that the species are being separated. Lighter species would come out at the top, and heavier species at the bottom. And each species would undergo various further chemical processes. As crude oil has been depleted, we need another way to produce all these fuels and chemicals. So chemical industries are actually looking for that another way to produce these chemicals in a more sustainable way. So we can use biomass, hydrogen, solar power, or that wind power for that sustainable production. So when you produce these chemicals, we need some special materials enabling all those chemical transformation, which is nanocatalyst. Actually, that the chemical industry have been used these nanocatalysts for decades, and now we have many powerful tools to precisely control the structure of these materials in nanoscale. So I'm wearing a platinum ring, which weighs about like 5 grams. And when you prepare the platinum nanoparticles with 10 nanometer of this 5 gram, the surface area would increase by 760,000 times, which with much more space for chemical conversion. And this is the power of that nanotechnology. The shape of the nanoparticles can be also controlled as catalyst. And here I show that the platinum nanocube with 7 nanometer. And the shape of the nanoparticles can catalyze the reaction in a different way. By doing so, that we can produce that some chemicals more or other than the others. So let me show you some real examples. That the most widely used industrial catalyst would be the zeolite. When you look at this nanostructure, it has very small and regular pores. And then that the pore size is typically less than 1 nanometer. And this zeolite catalyst have been used to upgrade the crude oil with higher selling prices. We could devise a way to synthesize the zeolite in a recyclable manner. The organic template can be clipped inside this 1 nanometer pores, then recombined into the original one for more zeolite synthesis. This zeolite have been used to produce gasoline from alcohol or to crack down all those chemicals or in a special way. Nanocatalysts have been the key the technology in various like alternative technologies. Fuel cell car has received a lot of attention, but they use too much amount of expensive platinum. So we have synthesized various shape and composition of the nanomaterials and use them as electrode for platinum minimization. Furthermore, that the platinum utilization can be minimized to put that the platinum atoms on the support separately. So the isolated platinum atoms would have a very unique and interesting property for chemical conversion. So when we apply them for formic acid oxidation, it's actively increased by that two orders of magnitude. The nanomaterials even can replace that the platinum. When you prepare the disensitized solar cell, platinum paste is often used. The various shapes of nickel sulfide nanoparticles, which is much cheaper material, were tested, and the rod shape showed even higher efficiency than platinum for the solar conversion. Nanocatalysts are also used for biomass conversion, that the ruthenium on carbon can convert cellulose into sorbitol. Previously, the toxic acid was used, but this material has no harm. So in my group, we've developed that the many nanocatalysts to produce high-value chemicals that are from biomass resources. New catalysts might be necessary to convert water and CO2 to various chemicals. The catalyst should be stable and active under solar irradiation and also abundant and non-toxic. A lot of people are working on this solar fuel, including my own group, but no proper catalyst has been found yet. So I think we have the 3 options now. We can use that crude oil more efficiently, or we can use that many alternative technology more actively, or we can try to develop something totally new. So we should seriously think what would be the best solution for sustainable production of fuels and chemicals now.